Dungeons have been out for 2 days now, and I'm pretty sure everybody has had a chance at playing at least the entrance floor by now. Whilst playing dungeons, you will notice there are some rooms with no enemies, but one chest, or sometimes three, and some strange contraption. These are the puzzle rooms, and show up in purple on the map. Luckily for you, most puzzles are impossible to fail, and you can eventually just mess around and find the answer by pure luck. But this obviously takes time, and for the ones you can fail, failing a room will make it impossible to get an S rank if your teammate dies more than twice. And if good loot is something you want, then you're going to want that S rank. So here's a guide on how to solve every single puzzle in the game with timestamps in the description. We're probably gonna be streaming on Twitch by the time of releasing this video, so hop on there and say hi and drop a follow for me to read out your name and make you feel good. That sounds wrong. Also subscribe, because I'ma be doing facecam streams at 50k subs. Okay, go, start video. The Blaze Room is one of the more complicated puzzles in the game, with no clear indication on what you should do to solve it. Upon entering the room, you will see there is a chest either at the top or at the bottom, and you cannot open it. If the chest is at the top of the room, kill the blazes in order of highest HP to lowest HP. If the chest is at the bottom, kill the blazes in order of lowest HP to highest HP. Use a normal bow whilst doing this, so you don't accidentally kill the wrong blaze, because killing just one blaze out of order will automatically fill the room. The creeper room features a large pole with a creeper floating on top and a lot of sea lanterns. You cannot fail this puzzle, but you can definitely slow yourself down by shooting all the wrong things. When you shoot two sea lanterns, a laser will appear connecting the two. And to succeed the puzzle, you have to make 4 lasers directly cross the floating creeper, and the pillar will explode, revealing a chest. Every puzzle will always have a sea lantern above and below the creeper, which can be used to get one of the beams easily. The Silverfish room is a room mostly made of ice, with a single silverfish with a block of TNT floating above it. To pass the puzzle, you have to hit the silverfish and it will go in the direction you hit it until it's stopped by a block. And you have to knock it into the chest, which is blocked off by ice. This room comes in an easy and hard variant, where the easy version can be solved in just 3 moves and cannot be failed, but the hard version can be failed if you make the wrong first move. So make sure to plan out the route the silverfish will follow before hitting it. The water room is a tall room with a huge glass display and 6 levers. This puzzle is also impossible to fail, but will slow you down if you make the wrong moves. The colored barriers blocking the chest correspond to the colored holes, and to open a barrier, you have to make water fall into the hole of the same color, and you can do this by flicking the levers which have a colored block behind them to turn on or off the same colored blocks behind the big display. Once all 5 barriers are down, you can collect the chest. The box room is the easiest puzzle room in my opinion. It features a bunch of huge boxes with buttons, and you can press the buttons to move the boxes in order to make yourself a path to the chest. Pretty simple and hard to mess up, because there is only 1 or 2 buttons you can press, and neither of them will cause you to fail. The warp pad room is a room with a chest in the middle, and a bunch of warp pads that take you to random other rooms with more warp pads. The easiest way to guarantee the chest is just to go diagonal from whatever warp pad you spawned in on, until you eventually get in the room. It is impossible to fail. The Tic Tac Toe room features a game of Tic Tac Toe, and you have to draw or win against the AI to get the prize. For a free bonus, this room always has a lever hidden here that opens a secret room near the leaves with another free chest. The ice floor puzzle has a nice floor that turns into packed ice when you walk on it, and you cannot walk back onto blocks you have already walked on. You have to get to the other side whilst also turning all ice blocks into packed ice 3 times, and then you can get the chest. Finally, the 3 Shady Dudes room, I don't know what to call it, but it's a room with 3 people and 3 chests, and they have a riddle. This room has 6 different riddles, and the 3 shady guys will tell you pieces of information that contradict each other in a way that will still allow you to decipher who has the reward in their chest. If you are bad at this sort of thing or want to speedrun, I will leave a link to a forum post by Klidgemart that has a list of all solutions to this puzzle, and his and Mageclass's forum post also helped me with the rest of this video. Make sure to drop a like if you found this video useful, and subscribe for more epic cool gamer content. Wow. Also, follow our Twitch, link in the description, we're streaming daily.